Hi everybody, it's me, Dave. I sometimes make games. I wanted to do a little tutorial for an Unreal feature that I don't see a lot of people using or talking about, but that I think is pretty powerful. So much so that it's become a major part of my level design workflow. Let's say you've built yourself a scene in Blender, much like what you've been watching me build in time-lapse right here. The scene is more or less done, and all the duplicate meshes have been created using Alt-D instead of Shift-D, so they are proper instances. We export an FBX. I'm exporting just the active collection. And I'm making sure to select Edge from the smoothing options in geometry. I then go to Unreal, drag and drop the FBX into the content drawer, click Import, ignore all the warnings that pop up, and drag and drop all the imported meshes into the level. And we're good. It looks just like it did in Blender, so it's fine, right? Well, not really. You might notice that the origins and transforms for all the meshes are the same. This isn't great, because it means the bounding boxes for the meshes aren't going to be calculated correctly. You'll also notice that there are way more mesh types than there were in the original scene. Literally, one unique mesh for every object in the scene. This is bad, because it means every object in the scene is its own draw call. They're also taking up more memory. And the combination of all these things means that the performance of the scene is much worse than it should be. Luckily, we can easily fix this by using the tool I mentioned at the beginning of the video that nobody seems to use. I'll start by deleting everything that I imported. I then go to File, Import into Level. I select the FBX that I want to import, and I select the project folder I want to import to. And now we get this new import dialog that has multiple tabs. There's a tab for the scene hierarchy. There's a tab for the unique static meshes in the scene. There's a tab for the materials. I didn't create any materials, so it's empty. And there's a tab for the skeletal meshes, also empty. The skeletal mesh tab also has the settings for importing animations. In the scene tab, there's also this hierarchy type dropdown. You can select from Create Scene Actors, Create One Blueprint Asset, and Create One Actor with Components, which is essentially the same as Create One Blueprint. I prefer to use Create Scene Actors, but it can be useful to use Create One Blueprint Asset or Create One Actor with Components. I'll demonstrate why later. So I select Create Scene Actors, and I click Import. I still get some warnings, but a lot fewer of them. These are actually degenerate triangle warnings, which just means I have some very small triangles. I'm still going to ignore them. And right away, we can see that things look quite a bit different than when we just drag and dropped. The scene hierarchy is the same as we had in Blender. And the origins of all of our objects are in the right place. But there is still one big problem. The scales for everything are multiplied by 100. And if we look at our meshes, they are all super tiny. The dimensions of this chair are 0 by 0 by 1 centimeters. This is going to cause a problem with Lumen because the distance fields will build wrong. We can fix this, but we have to change some export settings in Blender. So I delete everything again. Go back to Blender. And go to Export FBX again. This time I want to tick the somewhat confusingly named Apply Transform option. I say confusingly named because there is an Apply Transform option in the 3D view that does something different than the export option. We also need to be sure to set Z up and minus Y forward in the export settings. Double check that we're still exporting edge normals. And export, overriding the original FBX. We then import into Level in Unreal, using all the same settings as we did before. And that's much better. We can immediately see that our meshes are the right size in the content drawer, and the objects are the right scale in the scene. There is one sort of caveat to using the Import into Level tool, and that's the process for re-importing. If I right-click on the chair and select Re-import, I get a dialog that looks a lot like the original Import into Level dialog, that shows a list of everything that was imported from the original FBX. If I just want to re-import the chair, I have to deselect everything else in the list and then re-import. Okay, but what about using the Create One Blueprint option? Why might you want to use that? Create One Blueprint makes synchronizing the changes to the overall layout of the scene between the DCC and Unreal a lot easier. To demonstrate, I will delete everything I imported, again, and import into Level using the Create One Blueprint option. And you can see that I now have a blueprint with the same hierarchy as the scene from Blender. When I go back to Blender and look at the scene, I realize that I don't particularly love the way these windows are laid out. So let's change that. I think that works better, so I re-export the scene using all the same settings as last time. I go back to Unreal, and I right-click this FBX Scene Import Data Asset and select Re-import. This brings up a new re-import dialog that looks almost exactly like the original Import into Level dialog. And when we hit re-import, we see the layout of the scene in the blueprint has been updated to reflect the changes from the FBX. And that's pretty much it. I've been Dave. I sometimes make games. If you like this video, please hit the like button. If you want to see a longer version of the time-lapse that opened in this video, click the card in the corner. Have a nice day. Bye.